wouldn't mind just using social media to share this brilliant news with all your friends.
Welcome, Grand Tour fans. Last week we showed you the first part of the Grand Tour filming in Scotland for season 5. The three presenters drove in big American V8 muscle cars from the 70s. We ended our storyline when they were spotted in Aviemore on Wednesday. We learned now that they took their cars to Cairngorm Auto Repairs in Aviemore to do some modifications. What happened on Thursday is still unknown to us, but there are some rumors going around of the trio doing drag racing and driving on a track with the three in Scotland built cars. On Friday, the three presenters went back south to the place of Laggan, but not in the original three American cars they drove in. According to one of the villagers, the car where Richard Hammond in drove, a 70 Dodge Challenger, broke down at one end of the village. He stepped into one of the cars of the crew and they got him to a nursing home where they entertained the staff and the residents. Their visit was very much appreciated, and for some of them this will be something they tell around for many years to come. Clarkson and May arrived in what looks like a 1979 Chevrolet Nova and a Ford Mustang of about the same age. Saturday morning their journey continued. They were seen in Inverness at the Tour Service station where they filled up for their thirsty cars. The modifications were clearly to see on the vehicles. On Richard Buick Riviera there was a huge air intake installed which popped up out of the bonnet and a huge wing on the boot. James Cadillac Coupe de Ville had two massive side exhausts. The only thing noticeable on Jeremy's Lincoln Continental were bigger wheels. Other modifications were probably done in the interior and under the bonnet. After filling up, they were heading west to the Glen Doherty viewpoint, where they had a short stop and a beautiful view down the glen towards Loch Maree. Following the road, they came down to the glen into Kinlochery, where they filled up again at a local service station. There we got to see how massive the spoiler on the Buick Riviera really is. Later on they enjoyed their lunch at the Torridon Hotel. From Torridon they took a very scenic route through the beautiful Scottish landscape to Stafford, on the island Skye, where they spent the night. The next morning they continued their trip to Oig, where they took a ferry which would bring them to North Uist, one of the Outer Hebrides Islands. After boarding, half the deck of the ferry was used for the cars of the presenters and the crew. Around 11:30, they set foot on land in Loch Maddy, where they also had a short lunch before continued their travel across the island. We noticed that between Inverness and Loch Maddy, someone sticked a wedding picture of Prince Harry and Meghan just on the left rear wheel arch of James Coupe de Ville. We know James isn't a fan of monarchy and Jeremy recently lashed out to the pair, so we wonder what the story is behind this picture. Monday morning, Jeremy had a little trouble with his breakfast.
That one, so this time, very gently.
So this is the last fork of
this is the last fork.
Steady.
That couldn't be ever
wrong. No, you're going to do it. No, you're
not. It's the last one.
Now you're going to have to interview the Athenians.
When the problem was solved, they started filming at the stunning Valley Strand on the north coast of Nordjuist. Pontoons are being laid out at low water to provide a bridge over the tidal sands to Valley Island. They apparently enjoyed their time at this wonderful area, but after breakfast on Tuesday, with a decent knife and fork, it was time to leave. From the hotel they went to the Benbecula Airport, where a special chartered airplane from Air Wilmen brought the presenters and the crew back to the Oxford International Airport. For now, we would like to thank you for watching, and don't forget to share, like and subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much for watching. See you next time. Goodbye.